According to recent studies, it's estimated that 12.1 million people in the United States will have atrial fibrillation by 2030. Hi, I'm Dr. Paul Zai. I'm a cardiac electrophysiologist, which is a specialty of cardiology, and I am at Brigham and Women's Hospital. Atrial fibrillation, also known as AFib, is an irregular heart rhythm, which is a type of arrhythmia, and it also happens to be the most commonly diagnosed arrhythmia in the US and the world. The heart has four chambers. The top two are the left and the right atria, and the bottom two are the left and right ventricles. Normally, your heart's chambers beat in sync with each other, but during AFib, the signals to your heart become disorganized. The heart's two upper chambers beat chaotically and really fast. The contractions, in fact, are so fast that it makes the walls of the heart quiver or fibrillate. This causes an irregular, rapid heart rate, and it impedes blood flow through the heart. The chaotic rhythm in the atria is what distinguishes AFib from another related arrhythmia, atrial flutter, where the atria beat regularly, but faster and more often than the ventricles. Although AFib itself isn't usually deadly, it is serious and can cause complications. AFib can cause the blood to form clots, which can put you at risk for stroke, and it can also raise the risk for heart failure. The risk for AFib increases as you age. Other risk factors include high blood pressure, obesity, sleep apnea, European ancestry, diabetes, heart failure, heart disease, hyperthyroidism, chronic kidney disease, alcohol use, smoking, or enlargement of the heart's left chambers. So, what are AFib symptoms? Sometimes people with AFib don't even know they have it because they have no symptoms. Most people feel some symptoms, however, which can include an irregular heartbeat, heart palpitations, rapid fluttering or pounding heartbeat, lightheadedness, extreme fatigue, shortness of breath, chest pain, or even fainting. Anyone experiencing any of these symptoms should talk to their healthcare provider. So, let's talk about AFib treatment. In treating AFib, we take a holistic, four-pronged approach, so we look at the root causes, the symptoms, and also prevention all at once. These can include, first, risk factor modification, then controlling the heart rate during atrial fibrillation, controlling the heart rhythm, and preventing blood clots that could lead to a stroke. For risk factor modification, we evaluate the patient's underlying medical and lifestyle risks, and those that are relevant, we discuss and we address. These are things like hypertension, obesity, sleep apnea, or other factors. Heart rate control is usually done through medications to slow down the heart rate, but there are also implantable devices that can help control the heart rhythm, like a pacemaker, which is used when the heart rate is too slow during AFib, or sometimes when we perform what's called an AV junction ablation to slow down the heart rate. Heart rhythm control is usually done with medications, a cardioversion, or catheter ablation. Cardioversion is a procedure that uses large electrode pads that are placed on the chest to send an electrical current to the heart muscle, which resets the heart rhythm back to normal. Catheter ablation, also known as cardiac ablation, involves guiding a catheter through the blood vessels into the heart and destroying heart tissue in the areas of the heart that are causing the AFib, typically in the left atrium. Prevention of stroke is usually done with medications, specifically blood thinners. At Brigham and Women's Hospital, we perform more than 3,000 cardiac procedures every year. We're also involved in research studying technologies and techniques to improve our treatment options for patients with AFib. Thanks for watching. I'm Dr. Paul Zai. For more cardiac videos, click here. And don't forget to subscribe here.